Okay, key of F sharp still. So the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is in the number 3 box. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4, Now, there's a 6-5-4 on the first string right here. And there's going to be a 6-5-4 on the fourth string up the neck. And it's going to be about 5 frets difference. So as I make the shift, there's a 6-5-4. It was only 3 frets difference. So for the 6-5-4, 4-5-6, 6-5-4, 4-5-6, the second note in the sequence is going to be the last note. The second note in the sequence of the shift is going to be parallel or adjacent third note in the sequence. So the sixth note in the first string is parallel to the fifth note on the fourth string. So that's one way of measuring it out without feeling, to feel it out. So as I make this shift, I'm keeping in my mind that fourth finger. That second finger is going to go to where that fourth finger is, so I'm just going to shift up 3 frets, 2 frets. Thank you. 14, or the 5.
4, 5, 6, 5, 4, 5, 6, 5.